वेलकम टू आर्यन इंस्टीट्यूट प्रेजेंट्स नर्सिंग ज्ञान विद नियोला। टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस 10 मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस दैट कुड बी आस्क्ड फॉर योर नर्सिंग लाइसेंशियर एग्जाम्स। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इन चिल्ड्रन सस्पेक्टेड टू हैव अ डायग्नोसिस ऑफ डायबिटीज विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंप्लेंट्स वुड बी मोस्ट लाइकली टू प्रॉम्प्ट पेरेंट्स टू टेक देयर स्कूल एज चिल्ड्रन for evaluation. The options are A. Polyphagia, B. Dehydration, C. Bedwetting, or D. Weight loss. The answer is bedwetting, because in children, fatigue and bedwetting are the chief complaints that prompt parents to take their children for evaluation. Bedwetting in a school-age child is readily detected by the parents. Second question, a 3-year-old child comes to the pediatric clinic after the sudden onset of findings that include irritability, thick muffled voice, croaking on inspiration, hot to touch, sit leaning forward, tongue protruding, drooling and suprasternal retractions. What should the nurse do first? The options are A. Prepare the child for x-ray of upper airways, B. Examine the child's throat, C. Collect a sputum specimen, D. Notify the healthcare provider of the child's status. Answer is D. Notify the healthcare provider of the child's status. These findings suggest a medical emergency and may be due to epiglottitis. Any child with an acute onset of an inflammatory response in the mouth and throat should receive immediate attention in a facility equipped to perform intubation or a tracheostomy in the event of further or complete obstruction. Question 3. A client has been newly diagnosed with hypothyroidism and will take levothyroxine Synthroid 50 mcg per day by mouth. As a part of the teaching plan, the nurse emphasizes that this medication should be taken in the morning, may decrease the client's energy level, must be stored in a dark container, will decrease the client's heart rate. The answer is A. Should be taken in the morning, because thyroid supplement is taken in the morning to minimize the side effects of insomnia. The next question is, the hospital has sounded the call for a disaster drill on the evening shift. Which of these clients would the nurse put first on the list to be discharged in order to make a room available for a new admission? A middle-aged client with a history of being ventilator dependent for over 7 years and admitted with bacterial pneumonia 5 days ago. A young adult with diabetes mellitus type 2 for over 10 years and admitted with antibiotic-induced diarrhea 24 hours ago. An elderly client with a history of hypertension, hypercholesterolemia, lupus, and was admitted with Stevens-Johnson syndrome that morning. An adolescent with a positive HIV test and admitted for acute cellulitis of the lower leg 48 hours ago. The answer is A. The best candidate for discharge is one who has had a chronic condition and is most familiar with their care. The client in option A is most likely stable and could continue medication therapy at home. Fifth question. At a community health fair, the blood pressure of a 62-year-old client is 160 by 96 mm of mercury. The client states, my blood pressure is usually much lower. The nurse should tell the client to. The options are, go get a blood pressure check within the next 48 to 72 hours. Check blood pressure again in 2 weeks. See the healthcare provider immediately. Visit the healthcare provider within 1 week for a BP check. The answer should be A. Go get a blood pressure check within the next 48 to 72 hours. The blood pressure reading is moderately high with the need to have it rechecked in a few days. The client states it is usually much lower, thus a concern exists for complications such as stroke. However, immediate check by the provider of care is not warranted. Waiting 2 months or a week for follow-up is too long. Next question, what would the nurse expect to see while assessing the growth of children during their school age years? The options are decreasing amounts of body fat and muscle mass, little change in body appearance from year to year, progressive height increase of 4 inches each year, yearly weight gain of about 5.5 pounds each year. The answer is yearly weight gain of about 5.5 pounds per year. School-age children gain about 5.5 pounds each year and increase about 2 inches in height. Seventh question. A client is admitted to the emergency room with renal calculi and is complaining of moderate to severe flank pain and nausea. The client's temperature is 100.8 degrees Fahrenheit. The priority nursing goal for this client is maintain fluid and electrolyte balance, control nausea, manage pain, prevent urinary tract infection. The answer is C, manage pain. The immediate goal of therapy is to alleviate the client's pain. It's because of this pain the person might have had high temperature. Which complication of cardiac catheterization should the nurse monitor for in the initial 24 hours after the procedure? Options: angina at rest, thrombus formation, dizziness, and falling blood pressure. The answer is a thrombus formation. Thrombus formation in the coronary arteries is a potential problem in the initial 24 hours after a cardiac catheterization. A falling BP occurs along with hemorrhage of the insertion site, which is associated within the first 12 hours after the procedure. The next question is, a child who ingested 15 maximum strength acetaminophen tablets 45 minutes ago is seen in the emergency department. Which of these orders should the nurse do first? Gastric lavage PRN, acetylcysteine for age per pharmacy, start an IV dextrose 5% with 0.33% normal saline to keep vein open, activated charcoal per pharmacy. The answer is gastric lavage PRN. Removing as much of the drug as possible is the first step in treatment for this drug overdose. This is best done by gastric lavage. The next drug to give would be activated charcoal, then mucomist, and lastly the IV fluids. The last question is, which individual is at greatest risk for developing hypertension? Options for this question: A. 45-year-old African-American attorney, 60-year-old Asian-American shop owner, 40-year-old Caucasian nurse, 55-year-old Hispanic teacher. The answer is A, 45-year-old African-American attorney. The incidence of hypertension is greater among African-Americans than other groups in the US. The incidence among the Hispanic population is rising. Comment below your scores out of 10. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching. See you next time with 10 more multiple choice questions.